When shipping containers were invented, they revolutionised world trade. 99% of everything that comes in and goes out of Australia is by sea. Shipping is our lifeblood, and at the moment it's hemorrhaging. In the last year, the world has gone on a spending spree that's created a massive demand for ships and container space.
The world's consumers are now primarily purchasing their products online. That's put massive pressure on those global freight routes.
And it's driving the price of Australia's imports and exports through the roof. The cost to move a single steel box has skyrocketed in the last year from about $1,000 to nearly $5,000. The cost of bunker fuel and huge delays and congestion in ports around the world has the industry in a tangle. And then there's the performance of Australia's ports. Woeful, according to a survey by the World Bank. Of 351 ports around the world, Brisbane was our best performing, ranked 246th. Melbourne was ranked 302nd, Fremantle 326th, Sydney 337th, and Adelaide just 12 places off the bottom at 339th. The world's best performing ports have cranes moving a container every minute. Australia's ports can manage only half that rate or worse. Exporters are getting whacked too. Nola Pierce's company makes lifelike body parts and wounds that add realism for trainee surgeons, army medics and first responders. She manufactures and sells her products around the globe to military, police forces and industry.
The cost of the freight that we're putting on the bottom of that is often more than the cost of the, or equal to the cost of the items.
And it's not going to get better anytime soon. Jeff Parry, 7 News.